Hello, friends. I'm very excited today to be sharing with you a profile of a hero of mine, Luis Elizondo. He is a giant in the field of UFOs and is probably the most popular person in the media right now talking about them. He's from Miami, grew up Cuban immigrant family, and he was in the military, but then he ended up working for the Pentagon in the military intelligence wing all over the world for 20 years. From 2008 to 2017, he worked for the Advanced Aerospace Identification Program, or ATIP, which is a Pentagon program that works on UFOs or UAPs, unidentified aerial phenomena, as they call it, and the military. He ended up resigning in protest over the reluctance and the secrecy surrounding UFOs by the government. He just got fed up with it. And he went to work for To the Stars Academy. And while he was there, he accomplished two really great things. The first was he got released to the press three very powerful videos of UFOs. And the government reluctantly had to admit that they really were UFOs. And this was really big news, front page New York Times type of news. One was the Tic Tac video, the Tic Tac UFO from the Nimitz aircraft carrier. The other thing that he got accomplished was really quite significant. He had talked with a lot of these pilots in the Navy, and they said they had seen these UFOs, but they felt like they would be endangering their career or they would be subject to ridicule if they reported it, and the government would ignore them. Well, he got in place procedures to report these things, and they have actually an office that deals with this sort of thing now. And now, just this past month here in November of 2021, this has been extended to all the military. So it was a completely different atmosphere in the military towards this compared to in the past when everything was swept under the rug and you could endanger your career. He's been on 60 Minutes in the fourth biggest show they've ever had. He's been on CNN, Fox, Washington Post did a great online interview with him, and Esquire did a profile with him. I'm going to be showing a video that some selections I have of him talking in different shows, and it's just very powerful. Some of the things he says is just jaw-dropping. See what you think.
He hadn't given UFOs a second thought until 2008. That's when he was asked to join something at the Pentagon called the Advanced Aerospace Threat Identification Program, or ATIP.
The mission of ATIP was quite simple. It was to collect and analyze information involving anomalous aerial vehicles, what I guess in the vernacular you call them UFOs. We call them UAPs.
You know how this sounds. It sounds nutty, wacky.
Look, Bill, I'm not telling you that it doesn't sound wacky. What I'm telling you is real. The question is, what is it? What are its intentions? What are its capabilities?
Buried away in the Pentagon, ATIP was part of a $22 million program sponsored by then-Senate Majority Leader Harry Reid to investigate UFOs. When Elizondo took over in 2010, he focused on the national security implications of unidentified aerial phenomena documented by U.S. service members.
Imagine a technology that can do 600 to 700 G-forces, that can fly at 13,000 miles an hour, that it can evade radar, and that can fly through air and water and possibly space, and, oh, by the way, has no obvious signs of propulsion, no wings, no control surfaces, and yet still can defy the natural effects of Earth's gravity. That's precisely what we're seeing.
You know it's real. Not too long ago, as I mentioned, this would have been a joke, but now you've got a president, former president, acknowledging this. What changed that now we have former President Obama saying, serious now, there are things that we cannot explain?
Yeah, well, and it's not just former President Obama. We have former Director of National Intelligence Ratcliffe. We have former Director of CIA John Brennan, former Director of CIA Woolsey. all of them have come forward, along with some of our elected officials in Congress who stepped forward, all have received classified briefings on the topic. And what they're being provided is extremely compelling. I think, again, we are well beyond reasonable doubt at this point. So the real question is, what exactly are we dealing with? Are we dealing with some sort of foreign adversarial technology, or are we really dealing with something that is that's a paradigm moment for our species and dealing with something completely different?
For us to think that there was some sort of foreign adversary country right on the heels of World War II that somehow managed to evolve technologically 1,000 years ahead of the United States, and for the last 70 years it's been the best kept secret despite the billions of dollars we put into our intelligence community, doesn't make sense. It's so far beyond what you would consider common sense.
And then I know you got to get going. The Lonesome Space Cowboy, remember that last question that you couldn't get to, which was, if the general public knew or saw what you saw, how would they, what would the next week look like? How would the public react?
Somber. I think there would be this big exhale for about a day. And then this turning inward and trying to reflect on what this means to us and our species and ourselves. I think...
somber, sorry, like a sigh of relief?
Somber meaning serious. Not like Hollywood portrays people partying in the streets and silliness like that. I think you would have some people perhaps turning to religion more so. You might have some people turning away from religion. I think you're going to have, at that point, the philosophical and theological questions will be raised, and people will have some serious soul searching to do, no pun intended. And I don't think that's bad, by the way.
I'm going to conclude this by talking about something that Ross Coulthart described in his book In Plain Sight. Ross was, he has the highest journalism honor in Australia, very well respected journalist. And he studied this for a couple of decades, and he said that this is the most earth-shattering quote ever given by a either a government employee or a former government employee about UFOs. And in this, the interviewer on Fox News asked Elizondo, is it true that the government has debris or artifacts, is that what they called it, from UFOs? And Elizondo hesitated and looked like he wasn't going to answer. And then all of a sudden he said, yes, it is true. Oh my God, what a quote. That sort of changes the game. It's very interesting. There was no blowback from the military about this declaration that he made, but they did try to discredit him and say he never worked for the Pentagon. But then Senator Harry Reid, who had formed the Advanced Aerospace Identification Program, wrote a letter to the public and said, yes, he founded this, and that Elizondo was head of this agency for 9 years. That sort of put all of those rumors from the Pentagon to rest. I've really enjoyed sharing with you my portrait of Luis Elizondo. Thank you very much.